this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. It's May 3rd, the sun is out, the rain has stopped for a while, and we got a text this morning from our neighbor who said she had seen a hummingbird. That means that they're back. They're on their way up north to Canada and Alaska, but some of them stick around here, and the ones that are going on farther need nourishment. So she said, put your feeders out right now today. So we're following directions. We're helping the hummingbirds. I have my solution about to be ready. This is 4 cups of regular water, whatever water you would drink, mixing in 1 cup of regular old sugar. Yes, they like sugar.
Could you put honey in there?
I don't know. It just says sugar. I'm going with sugar.
Okay.
If you buy this stuff in the stores, it's all red and really pretty. Not necessary. And sometimes they have additives in there that you don't want birds to have to put up with. So just regular old water and sugar. And don't put in more sugar thinking, oh, they'll like it even better, just because we do. This is the formula they like, and so treat them to what they like. Now, I have 2 feeders. They would each take probably a quart, but you don't want your hummingbird food to stay in the jars for very long. It goes bad. So instead of filling them way to the top, I only fill them a little bit because then I don't feel bad if I have to pour it out and start all over again. It is so exciting to see them when they get here. We seem to have the ruby-throated hummingbirds. I don't think we've ever seen any other kind, have we?
I haven't learned to identify them, so I don't know.
Well, they have the red throat.
Yeah.
And of course the males are more brilliant than the females.
Why is that?
I don't know.
I guess we have to attract you women somehow.
I guess. Last fall, I did my due diligence. I cleaned out my hummingbird feeders so that they would be ready. Now, there's a variety of them on the market. Try 1 or 2 different kinds and see which works best for your yard. And these particular ones have this little well at the top that attaches, and that prevents the ants from crawling down from wherever you're hanging them and getting into the sugar water, because ants love sugar also. So this is filled with water, and then they can't get to the bottom of the feeder and get inside.
Do uncles like them as well?
What am I doing here? They probably do.
So then you just put water in the wells after you get them hanging?
Yes.
And that ends up drowning the ants,
right,
if they decide to come to the feeder.
Right, they will climb up on whatever you're holding your feeder on. And if the little well wasn't here, they would just climb down and get inside. So the rainwater can fill it up. If you don't have enough rain for it, then you just have to add some water. Off we go. Now this is another variety of hummingbird feeder that we've tried, not too successfully. They really don't care for this kind, at least ours don't.
Well, plus those end up with tons of ants and even wasps inside.
Yes. So there's one there, and we like to put it where we can see them, you know, why not? And I don't know, do we want to put both of them together?
Sure, we'll start them here.
Some people say they don't like to have conflicting.
Well, you want to put one on that other one?
We could. Why not? Yep. That should make them happy. They are also attracted by flowers, which is why at one point we put these flowers out here. That might even make it more of a signal that dinner's on. Come and get it.
In other words, if you feed them, they will come.
They will. Yes, they will. I hope they don't blow away today in this wind. But if you like hummingbirds, if you've never had hummingbirds, this may be a way to get some. You may not know that they are even in your neighborhood unless you put one of these up and you see them.
And even if you have an apartment or something, you can always put one out on your deck. You know,
that's
most
right.
Apartments have a little deck that you could put something
right.
on.
And some of our garden friends were concerned that, well, why are you feeding them sugar water? You should be planting plants that they can go to and get the real nutrients from. We have plenty of those too. This is just another quick way, like this is the McDonald's way. And if they get really hungry and need more nourishment, they can go to our many flowers.
Well, we literally have thousands of flowers that come up every year. So.
We do. And they're just starting now. So
yep.
If they're on their way, and they have flown now all the way from Mexico and the Caribbean, they need some food. So we're feeding them.
Yeah.
Well, it's time that we can put our ivy geraniums out also, and although I don't think the hummingbirds will be attracted to them, although they may, because they do have the nice little kind of a
trumpet
kind of flower, we'll put them out anyway. It'll just be like a sign saying, come and get it. So, and then the rain can water these, and then I won't have to.
Okay,
so I have three reds and two pinks.
So the pinks are going in the middle?
I'll have a red in the middle,
yep.
Pink on each side.
Okay.
So if you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd enjoy hearing from you. Questions, comments, tips for me so I know more about what I do. I'd love to hear from you, and we'll try to get to your answers as quickly as possible. We'd love to have you subscribe and join our garden family. Bye for now.
So what kind of sugar water are you going to feed me tonight?
Maybe ice cream.
Oh, ice cream. That sounds good. Are you going to hang it outside?
If you want me to.
It'll start dripping. I could just lie on the ground and let it drip in my
okay.
mouth. Okay. What kind of ice cream?
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Mmm. I'm ready.